Faith is a man's belief in the validity of a concept and the attainability of some goal.
There was a time not long ago when faith escaped Norma Heath.
I woke up one day and I couldn't concentrate. I couldn't think, I couldn't read, I couldn't write, I couldn't get out the bed, and then I started contemplating suicide. And I tried to commit suicide, ended up in the hospital where I was diagnosed with mental illness.
Heath says a childhood that included sexual abuse set her down a destructive path.
I started with marijuana and alcohol when I was 12 years old. I was being sexually abused from the age of 9, and at 12, when I picked up that joint and I started drinking, it gave me the courage to say no more. So the abuse stopped, but the drugs went on. My late 20s, early 30s, I started smoking crack. I was strung out on drugs, prostituting. Crack was the drugs that brought me to my knees.
On her knees, spiraling downward, the mother of three even admits to abusing and abandoning her own children.
One time she asked me to help her with her homework, and I just started beating her up for no reason.
It was decades before the death of a loved one brought her to rock bottom, a place where eventually she found her faith again and courage to pull herself out from the darkness.
My ex-boyfriend died in my arms. That was the turning point in my life when he died. I knew I had to do something because that could have been me. I saw myself in a casket. I ended up at Rosie's Place Shelter.
At this point, in her 40s, and finally drug-free, she credits small steps for bringing her to big places.
They helped me to start learning how to read and write again. We had a goals group, and in that goals group, I used to say things like, I want to go to the doctor's appointment, and different things like that. After I started hitting all those small goals, I said, I want to graduate from Harvard. So the girls told me, go ahead, Norma, we have your back. I did it. I went and I applied and I got in.
Homeless to Harvard.
I was shocked. I was really, really surprised.
In 2017, at the age of 51, Norma, who often stood in line waiting for a place to sleep in local shelters, stood in a diploma line, wearing her cap and gown, about to graduate from the school's extension program.
Norma Jean Stewart Heath.
When I walked across the stage to get my degree, oh my goodness, I couldn't believe it. It was a dream come true.
Armed with a bachelor's in psychology, she didn't stop there. Call her Reverend Dr. Norma Stewart Heath, now an ordained minister with an honorary doctorate degree, and the CEO of Amron International, an organization she began to pay it forward, helping other women overcome their own battles with addiction and recovery.
I help women to succeed in whatever they define as success. I'm giving back what was freely given to me.
And that's not all. Now invited inside some of the city's biggest companies to share her story, speaking at Biogen just a few weeks ago, providing motivation for some of the brightest minds in biotech.
This is like a second life to me. When I was out there on the streets, mentally ill and drug addicted, I was catching invisible flies out the air. And if I can come out of that, anybody can come out of anything.
An even greater gift. Norma and her daughter have survived the storm of their early years together.
She forgave me. She forgave me for everything I did.
To see her growth, to see her functioning, to see her able, you know, and strong, I love it.
No matter what your struggle, even if it is mending a fractured relationship, Norma says you have to make the commitment to mend yourself first.
Anyone can change their life. You have to want to do it. You have to have the faith that you can do it. You have to work hard for it, and you will get it guaranteed, I promise you.
Oh my goodness.
I know, what a story.
An incredible story. And Norma says really it was her family that helped her change her life.
Yeah, and as for what's next, she says continue to pay it forward. Mm-hmm. She's currently helping recovering addicts through art programs that are meant to provide an outlet for stress as well as provide socialization.
Well, if she can lead the way, I hope others can follow. Up next, living with disease and still living her dream.